Hello, I'm Divina de Campo, and I'm here representing Hedwig and the Angry Inch for Leeds Playhouse and Home.
It's amazing to have you tonight. What do awards mean to you, particularly ones voted for by audiences?
The thing with it being voted for by the audience is that it's not 15 people shut away in a room deciding, isn't it? You know, it's actually who wants you to win. So there's a bit more of a democracy, I think. And also it helps that I've got a really big following.
Definitely. And in terms of all of the iconic LGBT productions, can you talk about Hedwig and what it is about this show that has stood the test of time, that it remains such a vital piece of the live theatre experience?
Yeah, Hedwig for me was a kind of seminal moment. So it's amazing being able to embody that crazy character for the short amount of time that I was given her, and that we were trusted, that James... that John and Stephen trusted us with that, and that Jamie did such a great job with her. And we very much tried to put a 2022 lens over the top of it, you know, and UK specific as well. We tried to look at her through what does an audience want here right now, you know?
Do you think in some respects the themes and the subtext of the show, it's almost like the world around us finally sort of started to catch up with where Hedwig was, you know, all those decades ago?
Yeah, well, I mean, you think about where we were when it came out. We'd had the first trans winner for Eurovision with Dana International. You know, we were celebrating and seeing trans people. And then we've had this enormous media fueled backlash to trans people over the last 6 years, and this ridiculous moral panic that they're coming to get you. And we've seen it all before, haven't we? So that's a big part of why Hedwig was, for me, was so important.
And I think obviously the music is genuinely iconic. I'm curious if there's a particular song amongst that litany of classic numbers that means the most to you, that connects the most to you.
I said how Hedwig was a bit of a seminal moment for me. An origin of love, seeing that for the first time was that moment, because all of these origin stories are just made up. They're all just things that somebody sat and went, well, I think it was this. And for me, origin of love does that thing where it reframes all of those and goes, there's a place for everybody.
I'm either a wig in a box or a wicked little town man myself. And I guess, final question, can you talk about how important it is not just to celebrate the amazing wealth of theatre we have in our nation's capital, but everything that goes on around the country?
I think that's really important. We do have a bit of an issue that lots of theatre and lots of production is very London-centric. And so for me, having this performed in Leeds and in Manchester and then being here is kind of a big deal.